Think of the most fearful you've ever been. Multiply it by 10. Not even close. Multiply it by 20. Well, divide by 10 first, get yourself back down to zero, and then multiply it by 20. You're not even close. Multiply it by 30. Well, divide by 20, and then multiply it by 30. You're not even close. 40, you're not even close. 50, you're not even close.
How much do I have to multiply it by?
70.
So multiply it by 70 and I'm close?
You're a bit over. The sunlight was kind of coming through the trees and it just had a feeling, it was just a sense. The animals were a little bit more edgy, the undergrowth was a lot thicker. It just felt as though something didn't want us to go any further. And at that point I thought, we're nearly there.
We were sort of young bucks, really, young stags. We didn't really have that much experience. We lacked some of the skills that was necessary for such a expedition, such a labour-intensive trail that we were trying to cut with our machetes.
No, it's definitely this way.
Well, GPS is giving a reading in nor by northwest, which is this way.
Did Livingston have GPS? Did Scott have GPS?
No, but they both got lost and died.
Well, me and Rob have been together for years. We grew up together. We've shared absolutely everything. Laughter, tears, girlfriends. Only once.
People ask me, why do you travel? I tell them I travel to get to places, obviously. But not places like towns, but places in here and here.
So what's the most important piece of equipment on expedition?
Gloves.
Really?
Gotta protect your fingers. Can't do much without your fingers.
It's not.
Okay, you on, yeah? Okay, my most vital piece of kit is my bike. Okay? It's a Breitling Emergency Swiss watch. It retails at £4,000 and it's used by Air Force personnel, pilots and astronauts. The special feature that it has, if I was to press this now, a team would be alerted on the internationally recognised emergency beacon and they would come and look for us. If you press it and there's no emergency, then you're looking at a criminal record and a £10,000 fine, so you've got to be very careful. But I certainly wish we'd had it on our first trip. Shit. If I press it again, does it stop it?
Two very small men have appeared up ahead. And they don't look all that friendly. Rob, who are they?
They're both tribesmen. They've been tracking us since this morning.
Really? Never said anything?
No. But I knew. I sense them.
Well, they seem to be making a
strange sort of noise, a sort of humming.
They communicate by humming and telepathy. See if I can make contact.
Okay.
Many men making money on the moon. Many men making money on the moonshine.
Many
men making much money on the moonshine. It's not working. We met Natalie out there in a bar. We'd gotten really well with her. She was really smiley and bubbly, great personality. She asked us what we were doing. We explained how we were trying to search for this sacred cloth, and she showed a lot of interest in that. So I just turned to her and said, well, would you like to come with us? And she said, yeah.
Yep. This is the spot. Yeah.
Right.
Just brings it all back to just being there again.
Yeah.
Our tent was just over there, through there.
Right.
And Natalie's just to the side of it, and
yeah.
That's where Max saw her die.
We lost a team member. People say to me, how could you let that happen?
We did everything we could.
Yeah, she was as good as dead.
What? So she wasn't actually dead?
It's like, well, some people's scars are on the outside, mine are on the inside. Huh? Like a sword swallower.
It's difficult to tell, isn't it?
Well, not really. Did you feel a pulse?
Yeah, of course I felt a pulse.
And was there a pulse?
very faint. I mean, she was unconscious. She wasn't speaking.
No, no, no. You told me that you'd seen her die.
Look, I was a husk. It's difficult when you're a husk. If there's a line between alive and dead, she was on the wrong side of that line.
She's only on the wrong side if she's actually dead.
No, no, no. The line's further up than that. You can be on the wrong side of the line and still have a bit of life left.
You told me you'd seen her die.
Look, we had provisions for a couple of people for a couple of days, all right? We had a dying, a dead, all in but name team member. You add up the provisions, you divide by the number of living team members, and it's a simple equation. It's simple maths. It's death by maths.
In the book, you said, I saw her die. Yeah? I saw her drift away to another world, other adventures.
Yeah, yeah. Look, I did. She was shaking. She was making this croaking noise, like, ugh, go, 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 go. She wanted us to leave her.
I thought she was unconscious.
Then she slumped forward, like that. Gone, quick.
What's that? It's the bumbo.
Oh, fuck off! Fucking bumbo! Just fuck off, will ya?
Oh my god. Jesus Christ. Natalie.
Always keep moving forward. Even if you drop something, just keep moving. Well, depends what it is. You might have to go back. But never look back. That's the main point. You can always sort of back up and sort of, you know, feel behind yourself. You won't have gone far. But keep your eye on the horizon. Yeah? Always looking forward. Bear Grylls. Why is he giving himself a stage name? It's not Spectator Sport. Back in the 50s, two guys climbed to the top of the highest mountain in the world. It's Edmund Hillary. Woman's name? Didn't stop him getting to the top though, did it?